Good evening and welcome to our winter concert on this fine, beautiful Monday evening. The wind has died down, but it's still cold. I heard it's going to be like heat wave of 18 later this week. So. This is our jazz band. Right now we are actually in the middle of our preparation. We don't. This group behind me doesn't actually go to state contest until the first week of April, where we will do 3 to 4 songs during that. And as a total, with all the different days and stuff that we've had, I think we've had a total of 3 hours of rehearsal on these two songs. So they're doing very well. It's a little rough around the edges, but we still got a month and a half to prepare, so a month and a week or so. That last song was Children of Sanchez, a Chuck Mangione tune, and we featured Jordan up there on the flugelhorn, in case anybody was wondering what that weird-looking trumpet thing was. And, of course, Keenan and Emma on trombone and sax. This last piece that we're going to play is called Choo Choo Jaboogie. I played for a fundraiser for the Legacy Chorale in Brainerd, and this was one of the songs that we did, and I said, you know what, I got to take this to my group because I had a lot of fun playing it, and I think they have too. This will feature Emma Barkus on the alto sax.
Thank you.
of the fun things about our two-hour late start today that we did not get to rehearse. So we had a couple cop-outs, obviously, at the beginning. That one is a very difficult piece for these guys. It's extending the range and kind of getting them to where they need to be. And as being as first-year players, I'm very proud of where they've come from, or where they've come to. This next one here we're going to play is called Caribbean Delight. I know I've done this one before. Of the two, I think this is probably the more fun one for them. The other one is a little more challenging. I do want to recognize those people that will be participating in April in the first year honor band out in Moorhead. It is listed in your program, but if I could get Cassidy Bristow, Raina Hannigan, and Heidi Klein to stand up, please, and be recognized. This is Caribbean Delight. After that, we will have our junior high band.
Thank you.
This is our junior high band, grades 7 and 8. Today is the third time that they've played this music together. They got to play it on Friday and earlier this morning as a full group, otherwise they rehearsed separately. But I want to say publicly that I'm very proud of the 7th graders and how far they've come, and I'm very proud of the 8th graders for the fact that they're stepping up and kind of leading them to get into this, into the full group. They have a wonderfully big sound, and I'm very excited to see where this goes. I'm going to talk very quickly. I'm going to recognize those students that are listed in your program that will be performing tomorrow. We get on a bus at 5:45 in the morning to go to Duluth to perform at the Junior High Honor Band. They have three mass bands out there. The first two students I'm going to have stand up are those that were selected into the Gold Band, which is the higher of the three. That was Joe Zaxkowski and Destiny Rice. And what's really cool is their director tomorrow, his name is Michael Sweeney, and if you look in your program, you'll see his name about three different times in there. He wrote that last piece that we played. He also does a lot of arranging, and he will be the person that is directing the Gold Band tomorrow. Also selected to the White and Maroon Bands, which are two mass bands that are... Basically, they take all the flutes and they list them out, and then they go, okay, you seven go that way, you seven this go this way, and that's kind of how it works, and then if they have extras, they get cut. So, those that are attending with me tomorrow, if they can stand up and be recognized, we got Avery Sawyer, Kiana, Vonda Parsons, Annika Lindquist, I know I'm going to miss somebody, let's see, Ashley Champ, I'm going through all the people here, Cece Norman, Debrin, Hannah, and Michaela. See, that's eight. Did I miss anybody? Did I miss? Oh, Baron. That's okay. Baron, no, they all were so nice. This next piece that we're going to play is a real slow piece. It's the chorale from the song Jupiter. I'm sure everybody's heard the song Jupiter. You might not have heard this chorale part of it. It's part of Holtz the Planets, which is like 49 minutes long. So this is just a short little snippet of it, but this band really needs to learn how to play slow. So this is what we chose. So enjoy. Our last two songs that we're going to play today are some fun ones. The first one is called Carnival. It is written about the Brazilian festival Carnival. And our last piece is called March Bits and Pieces, and they took parts of 10, I think it's 10 or 11 different marches and kind of spliced them all together in little 4 to 6 bit or 8 measure chunks, and so you're going to hear a bunch of ones that you'll know it's Sousa marches and different stuff like that. So please enjoy our last two. As soon as we're done with that, we will be flip-flopping and bringing Senior High down. Seventh graders that will be going that have been selected to go to Moorhead. They are Avery Sawyer, Annika Lindquist, Alexa Tuchtenhagen, I'm sure I butchered that last name like I usually do, Brianna Hannigan, and Cameron Good. I also should point out that I've been dying to make a big pot of soup, but my kettle has been mounted back there, so Olivia could play that sound. If you didn't notice that, that is actually my soup pan that she was hitting. This is, of course, our senior high band. Our first song is called Into the Clouds, which will be our warm-up piece on Wednesday when we go to state contest. Our contest piece is yet to be determined on how we play tonight, but this next one that we're going to play is called Name Those Classics. It features a bunch of old songs. I have a really, really great prize if anybody can write down and guess and give me the names of all the great songs that are in this one. If somebody comes to me afterwards and has all the names of every song, you will have the great pride of knowing that you knew a lot more about classical music than most. And I'll give you a handshake or something. Well, I don't think that's a prize. This next one is called Name Those Classics. This was kind of, we were trying to figure out whether we wanted to do this one or not, and I said, what the heck, throw it in there. So this is kind of a fun one in the middle of the concert.
Thank you.
That was a wonderful esoteric setting of Shenandoah by Frank Tekeli. Features a lot of solos. It's a very advanced, mature piece, and I'm very glad that I was really excited to hear how that one sounded, and I'm really excited to hear how it sounds tomorrow. That's our first choice for when we're going to play on Wednesday. It's either going to be that one or the 1812 at the end. This next one is called Metroplex, and if you ask any of your kids, they're going to say they really love this song. I see people shaking their heads already. It's three scenes from Manhattan. The first movement is the scene as you're driving into New York and the sun is rising over the skyline. The second movement depicts kind of a jazzy nightclub. And then the third movement, which is everyone's favorite, including the flutes, because they get paid by the note, depicts a taxi cab ride. So you can imagine how much fun that is. So this is called Metroplex. I'm really excited to hear how this one goes too.
Thank you.
before we get ready for our last song, which is the 1812 Overture, I do want to thank you for coming, and I want to thank all the students for their hard work. We got two more days, then we get to kind of back around and go into solos, ensembles, and some more popular kind of fun music for the rest of the year. I will warn anybody, if anybody has a hearing aid or something like that, you might want to turn it down. Does anybody know what's special about the 1812 Overture? It has cannons in it. But I think the school and the superintendent would frown upon us bringing shotguns in to shoot into garbage cans, which is how it's generally done nowadays. So we have synthetically done it over the loudspeakers. So, and it, when I tested it earlier today, it kind of shook my chest a little bit. So just be prepared for that. This is the 1812 Overture. No. Thank you for coming. Have a wonderful evening. And if you can, please help us stack chairs and get equipment back to the band room. I would greatly appreciate it.
Oh, my legs hurt.